Hey everyone, and welcome to the 30th episode of The Happiest Hour on Earth. We are so excited that you are here, and we have a really fun episode tonight. We're going to be talking about the future of Disneyland as a park. We got some recent news about a Toontown renovation, and there's also some other things that have been in the works for a little bit. So we're going to discuss the news about that, but also just kind of our thoughts and what we would like to see during these renovations and refurbishments and all that good stuff. So we are so excited you're with us, and let's just get the show started.
All right, so tonight we're talking about the future of the parks, so it's going to be really exciting. There's a lot coming up in the next few years. For the drink tonight, we decided to go with another holiday cocktail.
Oh, yeah.
This is found at Trader Sam's. Obviously, we've never tried this in the park before, but we had to give it a try for tonight's episode.
I mean, we love Trader Sam's and we love the holidays.
Yeah, so it's
we gotta do it.
If you know us, you know we love Trader Sam's. We love our rum drinks. And this is like a very interesting sounding take on a tropical holiday drink. So we're gonna see how this one turned out. We'll let you guys know.
That's what we jump into. Let's go. Cheers. Oh.
Wow.
I like that a lot.
Oh, that is so much better than I thought.
This is, the reason why it's better than we thought is because this thing has rum, peppermint schnapps, ginger syrup, lemon juice, cream of coconut, mint leaves, pomegranate juice. And also it's rimmed, the glass is semi-rimmed.
Kind of rimmed with...
With candy cane.
Yeah.
So...
Didn't work out very well, but...
I feel like a lot of these holiday drinks that we have seen and the one that we made last week are so random. Like, it's peppermint schnapps with, like, fruity juices, and I just didn't know how good these things would taste, but man, this is good.
I know, I really had no idea what to expect with this one. We picked it because we're like, it's Trader Sam's, we have to just make what they created. But it's actually so much better than I thought it was gonna be. I like this one better than the one last week.
I did,
for sure.
Yeah, I do too. This one kind of reminds me of, let's say you got a mojito mixed with holiday spices.
Oh, that is so
right, because you got that mint in there, which is really, really good.
And like the cream of coconut tones down like the acidity of the pomegranate to where it just tastes really like creamy sweet.
That's really good. I could, oh man, and
big
the little
of
bit
one,
of peppermint in there is really, really tasty. So if you have not seen our reel yet, go over to our Instagram and see how I made this. I mean, I say if you're at your your family's house during the holidays, Thanksgiving or Christmas,
spice
bust this thing
up,
out
yeah.
and just have them have them love it. I mean, it's a lot of work.
There's a lot involved, but it's worth it. It's really
good.
It is worth it.
That's really good.
If you can get all the ingredients and get really good at making it fast, then do that. That's good.
It's amazing. So before we jump into the topic, I thought we should probably talk a little bit about some new stuff that happened. We did have Disney Plus Day on Friday. We are filming this on a Tuesday. And we also today got the Spider-Man No Way Home trailer. So let's start off with Disney Plus Day.
We had actually planned to have this episode be based on Disney Plus Day and everything that dropped and everything. If you heard our last episode, we said that that's what was going to be happening. So apologies. That's not what this one's about. But there was less announced and put on Disney Plus than kind of what we expected. I think we thought that there was going to be a lot more happening with that. So we just decided, like, maybe we'll just touch on it, but we're gonna make this one a little different. So.
Still a very fun idea. Two noteworthy things that happened on Disney Plus Day. We had seen one of these already due to Premier Access, but you had Jungle Cruise that came out for everyone to watch if you didn't want to pay for Premier Access. We absolutely love that movie. I believe we talked about it in one of our episodes when we talked about like what other rides could be turned into live action movies. So if you want to see that, you could find it on our page. Absolutely had a fun time with that. We weren't able to see Shang-Chi and the Ten Rings in theaters. So we did get to watch that for the first time on Disney Plus Day. That was awesome.
Yeah, definitely. That was fun. That was a really fun movie.
Yeah, I
really exciting.
Yes, yeah, so much adventure, like high action, very, you know, fast paced, and I love the whole adventure aspect of it too. Like it was stylized so well. The choreography was amazing.
And it seemed very so like authentic, you know.
It did.
I mean, there was even like subtitles because obviously it's supposed to be partially in China.
Yeah.
And so a lot of it was.
Yeah, I'm so glad that they did that. Yeah.
Yeah, because a lot of times it feels like they could add some more of that in when it's supposed to be based somewhere.
Yeah.
And everyone just speaks English. It's kind of like, well, you could make it more like realistic. Yeah. You know?
It was really good. It was a really good film, and we both enjoyed it so much. A couple of like notes for Disney Plus Day. Marvel had a great Disney Plus Day. They announced a lot of new stuff, even showed clips, you know, even if these things weren't even coming out for a few years, they still were managed to like show clips of the new shows, which was really, really fun. Mm-hmm. The one thing was I wanted to see more Star Wars stuff. We have a couple of shows in development and we didn't get to see too much. We saw a sizzle reel for Kenobi, which is going to be amazing. And seeing like Hayden, you know, practicing his lightsaber skills again in the mask. Really, yeah. Really awesome. Super short. I wish we had like a real trailer for Kenobi.
I know. I would think that there would have been on that day.
On that day, like, yeah.
Should have been.
The sizzle reel was cool, but that was the only Star Wars thing that happened besides under the helmet, which was a Boba Fett special that we watched. Cool, and that was really, really cool to watch. But I mean, Andor is in development, like pretty far in development. There's nothing new on that. There's a couple, you know, Mando is in development right now. Boba Fett, we got a trailer for, you know, a couple weeks before Disney Plus Day, but I just kind of wish we saw a little bit more from Star Wars. There's a couple other Disney Plus or Disney announcements on Disney Plus Day. You could find them, just search them. Really excited for a lot of the shows that they have planned. The Tiana show, which is going to be really, really cool. Hocus Pocus 2. A lot of other things that they announced, like movies that are going to go straight to Disney Plus. And I love all that. I mean, The thing is, Disney Plus has so much in development, especially next year. We're going to get some amazing stuff. But on Disney Plus Day, we didn't get too much revealed, you know, but the thing about surprising. Disney Plus is there's some amazing stuff coming. And I'm so glad that it's a service because we are able to see so many cool things that maybe wouldn't have happened if there wasn't Disney Plus.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
I'm super excited for everything that's coming.
I am stoked. Yeah, for sure. And then what was the other? Oh, Spider-Man trailer. We can go quickly on this. I mean, obviously, looks so amazing.
Pretty crazy.
I think this is going to be like one of the biggest Marvel films since
Endgame.
Yeah, since Endgame. I think it's going to be super emotional too. Like,
yeah,
seeing. I just know we're going to see. I keep wanting to say Peter Parker, yeah. Tobey Maguire, Andrew Garfield. We know that because we saw Doc Ock, Green Goblin. Electro from Andrew Garfield's Spider-Man's. And I think this is going to be really, really amazing, but also really, really sad because I've heard rumors that this is going to be Tom Holland's last like MCU Spider-Man film.
Wow. I hadn't heard that.
So pretty crazy. I think there's some back and forth between Sony and Marvel. I think he might join the Sony universe for a little bit and then come back to Marvel. I'm not really sure. So going to be very emotional, but it's going to be very, very good. But with that, should we jump into our topic, starting with Toontown?
Yeah, I'm pretty excited about this because, I mean, I've always kind of loved Toontown in a way. It was never like my favorite place to hang out, obviously, but it's fun, but it's definitely been in need of something new.
And I feel like when I walk into that land, I just kind of go do a little
make
circle,
your rounds, like
maybe
go see
Mickey's house, but do a little circle.
Roger Rabbit,
out, you know?
Maybe. But it's kind of just like you pass through. Like for little kids, I think they love it, but I think that they're going to love it even more now,
even more.
Which is great because now it's going to be geared a lot towards them and apparently parents as well. It sounds like it's going to be a good update
Yeah. So they're making it a lot more. Well, so one thing that we knew is Mickey's Runaway Railroad. Oh my gosh. Why did they have to pick this name? Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. There we go. I can't believe I said that.
That's they good. Should have named it something else.
I think they did that on purpose so like kids could have fun like saying it, but adults are just stressed out. They're like, yeah, why can't I speak
don't
English?
Don't make me say this again.
Runaway Railway. We knew that was coming in 2023. And actually, first it was originally going to come out next year, 2022. They pushed it back to 2023. And it looks like the reason why they did that was the ride might be done before then, but they're closing Toontown for a while. And they're going to make they're going to change some things up. Oh, and the nice thing is it's getting another, like it's like an e-ticket attraction that is going in this land that has been kind of an, you know, afterthought for a lot of people. Roger Rabbit's really fun. The Gadget Go Coaster is fun for kids, but like I don't think a lot of adults like go seek out that ride, you know.
Oh yeah, Mickey's Runaway Railway is going to draw a lot of people.
It's going to bring so many people. And let me just read this little section here, just so you guys, if you haven't read this, this comes from Disney Parks blog. If you haven't read this, this kind of brings just kind of the vibe that they're going for with this renovation. It says, building on the legacy of Mickey's Toontown, Imagineers are working to create some all new experiences so families and young children can have more opportunities to play together inside Disneyland Park. The beloved Mickey's Toontown will transform into a vibrant symphony of sights, sounds, and sensations. Focusing on today's families with young children, Mickey's Toontown will feature new play experiences as well as open, grassy play areas for everyone to unplug. The land will have landscaping for both spontaneous family play and parental relaxation.
I like the sound of this.
Yeah, it sounds amazing. And
as
so that,
a parent, yeah. I'm stoked about this.
In the front section, they're calling Centennial Park. So that's going to be most of the section that they redo. It's going to be very green, very kind of organic.
There's going to be this
like tree that's there that's supposed to be reminiscent of Walt's like wishing tree, like where he would just sit at this tree and like reminisce or like think about, you know, the future that he is going to have. So that's going to be so
much fun. Which is what
I
love about this idea. And we were talking about this the other day is like, this was like Walt's whole goal in creating Disneyland was for it to be a place for parents and kids to have fun together, which it already is. But it's just cool that they're kind of theming Toontown now even more towards that goal.
Yeah. Because I think the parks become so busy, and yes, this area might get very busy as well.
Yeah.
But true. The parks are about we're going from land to land, and there's like a destination that we're trying to achieve, you know? Where I feel like with this Centennial Park that will be in Toontown, it's a place where you just go and just can hang out for a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And I like that because California Adventure has that.
Yeah.
We've talked about this, the Wilderness Redwood Explorer Creek. Area, like the, yeah, Redwood Creek Trail or whatever.
Yeah. Yeah. And Disneyland doesn't really have any area like that until now, or it won't until that's created. And I think it's been in need of that because especially the parents in Disneyland, I think, are just sometimes in need of somewhere to go to just like, let their kids kind of
roam and
just them like sit and relax for a little bit. And there's not really anywhere like that in Disneyland. Like Main Street is always bustling with people, and in the lands, it's always crowded and there's no wide open spaces. So I think this is going to be needed.
This is going to be very great. And like one other thing, like, I feel like we used to have something similar to this with that ranch. Remember the ranch that was Galaxy's Edge, you know, before?
Yeah.
There's, like, an open area where there's, like, some livestock there. And all this. We never used to go in there. I think families used to go in there a lot because it was very separate from everything.
Like, at Halloween, that's the only time I remember going because that's when they would, like, have character meet and greets and stuff and like some Halloween themed stuff, which was fun.
Yeah.
But I don't remember really
But when when we went in there for that, like, it seemed more open and more relaxed, right? But mm-hmm. now that that has been taken over by Galaxy's Edge, and, you know, I love Galaxy's Edge, so I'm glad that that took over. But now there was really no place for a kid to just kind of run around without the bustle of people trying to get from mm-hmm. land to land. You know, it was very separate. And so now I think with this... this new Toontown renovation, it's going to be great.
I think it will be too. And I'm curious to see what some of the things that they're like alluding to will be, like the like play and games and stuff. Like, I don't know what they're going to do, because I mean, obviously we all know of, like, you know, the like gag area or whatever, like where you can play and, you know, pull the dynamite and like all that random stuff. Yeah. So I don't know. I guess they'll probably change all that and do some more interactive stuff.
Yeah, I feel like it's going to be very, like, park-oriented. Like, from the concept art, it looks like there's that huge tree, but then a lot of the roots are going to be, like, coming out of the ground where kids can just kind of, like...
maybe.
Yeah, hang out and play. There's going to be, like, a new fountain structure there. They'll still have, from what it looks like, the houses where they could go in and play.
That's good. I'm glad they're not changing that, because that is the one part that I love.
Yeah, yeah, same here.
So fun.
And I think it just adds to that, right? Because, like, Goofy's house and, like, Chippendale's treehouse or whatever, like, there's a lot for kids to do there. Mm-hmm. But just adding a little more openness to that land, I think, is going to be great. So
I think that's
I'm very, very excited for this, especially as a parent. And honestly, just as, you know, me before I was a parent, I was kind of like, Toontown, if they wanted to expand Star Wars land, or if they wanted to expand like fantasy land, like, I'm down with that. Just like take it out, like just expand.
Mm-hmm.
Now being a parent and them coming up with this idea, I am all for renovating it. Like, I thought it was weird when they were just doing Mickey's Runaway Railway. I was like, they're going to put this like huge e-ticket in there in this land that no one really goes to that much. But then now that they're renovating it, it's going to be more appealing to go there.
Yeah.
And that you have that e-ticket ride. It's going
to totally
be great.
I was going to say that too. Like, leading up to this, I feel like there was talk about it maybe just going away and then replacing it. And I was kind of back and forth about it, because I knew that a lot of kids loved it, and I, you know, had some things that I liked about it too. But I think that this was probably a good way to go about changing it up a little bit. I think it's going to be really good. I wonder how long it's been in the works, you know, because with
Mickey's Runaway Railway coming.
Yeah.
I'm sure they were like, should we like actually renovate the land too?
Yeah. I mean, it makes sense because, you know, Disneyland has such little space to work with in terms of like expanding. So they really have to kind of figure out what that's already there can be updated and made, you know, more fun, I guess.
And actually, on that topic, we should talk about Disneyland Forward, which definitely ties into the amount of space that they have and what they can do about those restrictions. So with Disneyland Forward, you might have heard about this before. This project is very...
Vague.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, very ambiguous, very, like
not a lot of details.
Yeah, so this proposal that they announced, it's not like specific plans. They're not like, hey, we're going to build a Neverland, or we're going to build, you know, an expansion to Marvel Land or something like that. It's not like that at all. I'm going to break it down in the best way that I can. So with Disneyland Forward, what their main purpose is here is to appeal to the city of Anaheim to change the restrictions that they've had ever since the 90s. So I think they signed around the 90s, kind of like an expansion plan. Maybe that was when they're, you know, going to do Disney's California Adventure. Pretty much this proposal that they signed gave them specific amount of space, but every area needed to be used for a specific purpose. So there's going to be retail, right? Downtown Disney. There's going to be hotel space allotted to Disneyland. There's going to be theme park and ride space that was only supposed to be used for that. Now, Disneyland doesn't have a lot of space to work with, unlike Disney World. what Disneyland is trying to do right now is say, hey, we have a lot of space that can only be used for hotel areas due to this like contract we signed in the 90s with the city of Anaheim, but we don't want to build another hotel there. We would love if we could find ways to expand either like the theme parks or the retail and like also just integrate. You know, we don't want to be bound by this section, you know, only has to be retail. This section only could be theme park. This section could only be hotel space. So they want to renegotiate their terms with the city of Anaheim so that they can integrate a lot of new experiences where they couldn't before. And so their whole proposal here is that with the current structure, if they wanted to expand and add new properties and new rides or whatever the case may be to Disneyland, they're kind of at a point where they would have to take away something that people love in order to build something new there. And so they're pretty much just with Disneyland Forward saying, hey, can we revise this contract so that we can expand and, you know, expand the park outside of the boundaries that were previously set and everything. So some of the things on the site that they talked about Tokyo Disney, how they're getting a Neverland, an Arendelle, and a Tangled Area. Corona, that's the kingdom. But yeah, no, terrible. But the kingdom of Tangled and all this stuff. And they're saying, hey, like if this goes through, we have the opportunity to, you know, build something like this because we can expand. I know in the concept art, they even have like a Wakanda area. Like, you know, they're in the concept art, they're just showing the different possibilities. Now they haven't set anything up saying like, if we get this proposal approved, we're going to build this or going to build that. Their only focus is to change that. I want Disneyland so bad to expand, and I don't want them to take away things that are so, you know, crucial to the parks. I mean, over the past couple of years, they've like taken up cast member areas and things like that because they've wanted to expand and they've moved them off like property and stuff like that. And I just want them to have the ability to do more with the land they have and not worry about like, you know, having extra space for like a hotel, but they don't want to build another hotel there. So why can't it be used for theme park, you know?
That's true. And that's I feel like they've already kind of had some like beef with Anaheim too. Like Anaheim hasn't been really happy with just how, I don't know, like,
well, I mean, the thing is
they do bring a lot of tourists and stuff. And
a lot of money, and but also, you know, people's jobs. Like you're providing opportunities for the people of Anaheim. I don't live in Anaheim, so I don't really.
We don't really know how it works.
But I feel like Disneyland has done so much for the city of Anaheim.
Yeah,
and maybe those. And the thing is, the reason why those you know smaller shops along Harbor or Catella are doing so well is because of the tourism that Disneyland brings. If Disneyland wasn't there, I don't think
there wouldn't be much happening in Anaheim at all if it wasn't for Disneyland.
So it's really a fine balance. Yeah, I mean, like all the hotels and everything too. So like,
it's just that it does continue getting more and more crowded and more people coming every year, even from out of the country.
Yeah,
like from everywhere. So it's like, I understand that it is, you know, it kind of causes issues here and there, but it is also helping things too. You're right.
Yeah, I just hope they get the proposal done and are able to appease the city of Anaheim and expand, because I need to see Disneyland expand. It sucks that we have so much more limited space than Disney World.
Yeah, it's a bummer. They have to just kind of work with what they have.
Yeah,
it's a bummer. You know what area I was just thinking about that like there's nothing going on right now, and we've talked about this area before, but the theater by Toontown, there's like nothing going on there. It's where Mickey and the Magical Map used to be, which we loved, and it's gone, but it's just sitting there now. It's weird that they haven't done anything with that.
I hope that they bring another show back there.
I hope they do too, but I feel like they won't. Theater.
If they don't, then yes, it should be a Fantasyland expansion. I would love that. I would love a Fantasyland expansion.
You don't think
expansion.
It would expand even from Toontown into that area? Probably not.
I think they
have enough space to work with there.
I think when they're weighing like Fantasyland and Toontown, like Fantasyland would bring a lot more people. Mm-hmm. I would like to keep it a theater, but I feel like there is some opportunity around there.
It's huge.
Oh, yeah.
There is so much space there. I don't know what they could do with it, but...
It is pretty big, yeah.
They could do something.
Yeah. There's some areas that I think we're not even aware of mm-hmm. that Disneyland owns, but it could only be used for certain things, so it just kind of seems like empty space.
Yeah.
So hopefully if they redo that proposal, they could...
Yeah. I think it would be good to be able to, like... revamp and just be able to like redesignate areas for new things
for sure.
All right, so another thing that has been kind of talked about, kind of in the works for the last like year or so, I guess, is the Splash Mountain to Princess and the Frog refurb that's coming. So let's kind of chat about that real quick.
Yeah,
I guess we don't have a whole lot of update on when that's happening. They kind of just announced that it was going to be happening and then nothing for a while. So we've talked about it a little bit, and we kind of feel like if it's going to happen soon, that it'll probably be like winter time.
It would make sense.
It makes the most sense because you get soaking wet on Splash Mountain. So probably... winter is a less popular time for people to go on it in general. So it's probably the best time to close it down for a while.
The only thing I'm thinking is I would have thought December, right?
But they would have announced it.
They would have announced it.
Now.
I don't think they're going to.
Beginning of the year, January, February.
Maybe, yeah.
That's when it gets really cold and rainy.
Really,
and
yeah.
Uncomfortable.
Because I don't think they're going to be like, in 2 weeks, it's going to be closed and all this stuff. I think they're going to make a spectacle of it, right? Like, I think they're going to be like,
they're
going to
want
Splash Mountain, like, get on Splash Mountain before it's closed. They're going to, like, I think they're probably going to sell us some, like, Splash Mountain merch, all this stuff. I'm sure they're going to, like, try to get as much out of it as possible. So I don't think it's going to be. Yeah. So I don't think it's going to be in December.
I don't think so.
Maybe in the new year.
I think probably in the new year.
It will
I think
have
it's
to be during
like,
the colder season.
Colder, yeah. I would say January, February, maybe March. But yeah, I think they're going to give people a little heads up.
Yeah.
A little like ahead of time warning so that if they are going to do a trip, they can make it happen.
To
ride it before it's gone.
I agree. And then I think it just makes sense that it'll be in wintertime. And then maybe, I don't know how long these projects usually take.
I think a while, but.
But I think they would probably try to get it open by like summer.
I don't know.
I think they're working on, they must be working on the animatronics already, like in a facility, right? Working on them
maybe.
And then just implementing
them
into.
Yeah, that's true. I guess there's
right,
certain
so like
that,
they're doing things behind the scenes, I would have to assume.
Yeah, because I think that they're going to leave a lot of the actual animatronics, like the moving part of it, and just put new characters over them. Because that would just make the most sense. I mean, there's already characters that would be fitting in both of those.
Yeah, either that or, like, I think they'll probably, like, repurpose a lot of the animals in there.
Yeah.
There's going to be a lot of the same animals we'll see because those animals weren't specific towards, like, you know, Splash Mountain, and they can definitely be reused and animated.
Yeah.
For like, they could probably just like change it a little bit, and then they're singing like Dig a Little Deeper instead of, you know.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, in the movie itself of Princess and the Frog, the only animals you really see are frogs and alligators.
There's the birds when they're singing Dig a Little Deeper, like in Mama Odie's like place. Like, there's a lot of birds like dancing and singing.
Yeah, that's true.
I could see them reusing those, and they already reused those from the America Sings. Yeah. So I could see them just carrying that tradition on, just as like backfill characters, you know?
Yeah.
And the interesting thing about this is that the last we heard, this is going to be an original story that isn't really following the movie storyline. So they could honestly keep as many as they want and just be like, oh, it's just these a part birds of the singing. Story. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, we've talked about that a little bit too. We don't really know like what time frame in Princess and the Frog it's going to be touching on, like this the ride.
I did hear that it's going to be humans again. They're like going to be prepping for a Mardi Gras parade or something like that.
Oh, I hadn't heard that. That's interesting. Yeah. So they won't be frogs. If they are human, then that means that Dr. Facilier would be no more. Because, right, in the movie, he's gone.
He's dead, yeah.
So I don't know if they'll just, like, pretend like that never happened and still have them be in there. Because, I mean, like, when you're heading up the hill to do the drop, that spot would be kind of perfect for, like, the friends on the other side and, like, the shadows and all that stuff.
So I know, wouldn't that be perfect? Yeah, it would be perfect.
But, yeah, I don't
know
what
they're
going to do about
that part. A reemergence because of something. And yeah. I would love to have a villain in the ride.
He's going to have to be in. I feel like they'll have him there.
Yeah.
Probably. I don't know how they'll incorporate, but it would make sense to me for him to be there, especially in that spot.
Especially in that spot would be great. Yeah. And so
it's like a villainous spot. You're about to like do the drop. Like,
do the drop. Although the other interesting thing here is that the drop, instead of that like big log thing, you're going to have Mama Odie's like boat up in the log. So if you do the Dr. Facilier drop there and it's out of Mama Odie's boat, like that would be interesting. Like, look here. Like, so that's the drop. And then that's like where Mama Odie lives, right?
So you're coming out of the boat.
I mean, you're coming out of here, but the boat is like in the tree, right? So like, but that area should be kind of like Mama Odie's. So I don't really know, but it is kind of exciting being like, I have no idea what they're going to do. I would like some sort of darkness, you know, some sort of villainy.
Yeah, there should be a villain
of some kind. Yeah, kind of like, yeah, Splash Mountain, you know?
Yeah.
How's that? And I'd love to like carry on that tradition of that. But that being said, do you think now with Princess and the Frog, you know, New Orleans themed, do you think they will expand New Orleans Square to Princess and the Frog, and or do you think it will be, you know, Critter Country still?
It would only make sense to expand it to there. Like, it's literally right next door to New Orleans Square, and the movie is in New Orleans. Like,
yeah,
I feel like they have to expand it to there. There's no reason not to.
Yeah.
And Critter Country is already so small.
It's not really a country.
Yeah.
It's like a state right now.
Exactly. Yeah. It's a little, maybe a city.
Yeah.
But yeah, we had talked about how they could kind of theme or repurpose that area a little bit. I don't know if you want to mention what you had.
Thought. So if they expand New Orleans Square, which is my favorite land, like, so I wouldn't be really too bummed there. But if they expanded New Orleans Square through, you know, the Princess and the Frog ride, there's a couple of things that they could do. They could either have Critter County instead of Critter Country, right? Like a very, like a smaller version of it. They could do like 100 acre wood, which is just a very small version of Critter Country. And it's just where you could find all your poo, you know? It's just
all
everything. Everything Winnie the Pooh. It's, you know, maybe you create a couple new things over there, but it's just
they
100 acre wood.
Keep Hungry Bear, but make the bear be Winnie the Pooh, which would make sense anyways.
Yeah.
He's a bear. And like, just have everything.
Retheme that restaurant just slightly. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
And have a 100
and then you have
theme.
His ride right there and
the candy
store. So it would all just be kind of the Winnie the Pooh spot. I feel like that would make sense.
And you could like do a slight little renovation to just make it feel a little more, everything just a little more themed to Winnie the Pooh. And then that could just be a little tiny little slice of 100 acre wood.
But I wouldn't want them to get rid of like the character meet and greet either, which is outside.
Exactly.
That's such a fun little spot. But it is kind of weird how like the outlet for Splash now, but yeah. At that point,
they might have to like redirect some things or like maybe like block it off somehow. But
because it would like intermix a little bit.
Yeah.
But I think that would make sense to do.
I grew up a lot more on like Fantasyland stuff, but there are a lot of families that like really dive deep into Winnie the Pooh with their kids. And so this could just be like a smaller little portion of the park that is dedicated to Winnie the Pooh. And I would be fine with that.
I would too. I love that area. And I wasn't a huge, huge Winnie the Pooh kid growing up.
Yeah.
But it's still really special to me, even though.
Especially after Christopher Robin. I really enjoyed that.
Oh, totally.
That was a great movie.
It's really nostalgic and just hits you in the feels. I feel like I would love to have that whole area just kind of dedicated to Winnie the Pooh.
Honestly, you could probably and this might make some people mad, but honestly, that shop is very big. You might even be able to cut the shop just a little bit and add a little more Winnie the Pooh theming, like do a bigger like Pooh Sticks bridge or like whatever, you know, add some more like elements like that. There's where it just kind of feels like a corner of Winnie the Pooh.
Yeah, I think my thought probably doesn't make sense. I was just thinking that like just outside of the shop. So it's like the candy shop, the shop. Where you can buy clothing and stuff. And then right outside of that, it's just kind of a little open area.
Open area, yeah.
It could expand it a little further, but then I realized that I think that that's kind of like a cast member.
There's a little bit of a cast member area, but like they've done before.
They could
rearrange things, but I think I would be really into that. Now, another possibility that I could see them doing is with that restaurant space there, I could see them continuing New Orleans Square into Hungry Bear and doing like Tiana's restaurant, which I would be, you know, fine with too. I would love a Tiana's restaurant. I think that'd be really cool. But then that just only makes
Critter Country
smaller or 100 Acre Wood.
Yeah. That point, if they were going to get rid of that, like you might as well just get rid of the whole area, because I think it's weird to just have the ride and the shop.
Yeah.
That's kind of like so tiny, just that teeny little corner.
Yeah.
I think it would make more sense to keep Hungry Bear. I think a lot of people love that place.
Yeah.
And maybe make Tiana's restaurant somewhere else. There are a lot of restaurants.
Yeah, there are a lot of restaurants. Yeah. Why not? Why not retheme one area to that?
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, I always mix up all the names of the restaurants.
I know. In New Orleans Square.
Because there's like three or four of them. Point being, they could change the theming of one of them and the name to be more Tiana.
I agree. Themed. Yeah, I agree. And
Market
that's
House,
the one like
French Market.
French. Yeah, no, there's a lot of
and
markets.
And then there's like one more. Like, yeah. That's very New Orleans.
Yeah.
Style.
But my thing is that I'm very excited to see what Disneyland does with this, because it's a very like, you know, it's like, it could go so many different ways.
Yeah.
What are they going to do? And
it's like the Marvel show. What if?
Yeah. What if?
This way. It could go that way.
What if we turned everything into New Orleans Square? Yeah. I think I would be fine either way. I think they need to keep Pooh. I think the ride Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh is amazing.
They can't get
rid of that.
I love that ride.
So I do need a separate land there, but I do want them to expand New Orleans Square in a way. But then Square infers that it's a certain tiny section and not a big thing.
And it's already, it's not big. It's not big.
But you have
it's
two of the
bigger
best
than a square.
There, yeah.
Yeah. It's yeah. like, I mean, it does expand pretty far.
So like, do they change? No, they don't change the name.
Change the name. But it would make sense. It definitely makes sense for the Tiana ride to be a part of it.
Yeah.
I mean, I agree. Come on.
You might just have to change the exit and the entrance a little bit. I would be
Which they could
them.
Probably easily do. If it's going to be closed down be for a long to. Time, yeah. they could rearrange everything.
Yeah.
You know? I don't know. It's going to be interesting. It's all going to be very off-putting. I'm just I love Splash Mountain, so it's going to be a hard transition to just not have it there anymore.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm excited about this one for sure.
It's going to be very interesting. It's going to be
sad. Like a piece of my heart's going to be gone when I'm in Disneyland.
Yeah. Yeah, Princess and the Frog is like one of our favorite like Disney movies. We love it so much, but there's just something about hearing.
Yeah, the pretty doodah being there. And yeah. All those characters and stuff.
It'll be very interesting. I'm very curious to see what they're
I'm very curious to see and how long of a process it's gonna be. Like you said, you think it'll only be like winter to summer. But
I don't know. Yeah, that's way too short. I think it's gonna be at least
probably at least a year.
Yeah.
I don't know, but then it would open when it's winter, which would be weird. Yeah. So I don't know. I don't know.
We'll see. So that is pretty much it. I think the only other thing that you know is in my mind that will be expanded to, and they've talked about it, but we haven't heard anything since, is going to be an Avengers campus where the Quinjet is, you know, on top of that big building where they do a lot of the Marvel shows. That originally was going to be, and I know they're still working on it. I know there's a lot of budgetary issues with the park being closed for over a year. But that is going to be turned into an e-ticket Avengers ride. And, you know, I wasn't unfortunately able to go onto Web Slingers. I was right at the front and then the ride broke down and I wasn't able to go on it. I've heard mixed reactions about it, right? Like, it's a cool version of Midway Mania, or a very tiring version of Midway Mania. All this stuff. I think that, you know, just like Star Wars, they opened up with Smuggler's Run. People were like, this is fun. It's really cool to be in the Millennium Falcon. But then when Rise of the Resistance opened up, they're like, this is the main attraction. Like, this is what everyone's here for. Now, I really hope that the Avengers ride isn't too far behind. We have not heard any updates for a very long time. But the ride system that is going to be used, from what it sounds like, and this could definitely change, is going to be kind of like almost like Star Tours meets Flight of Passage. I think that you're going to be in like a flight simulator type of thing with everyone else. And then it's going to break off into like almost an individual ride experience where you're like kind of in a jetpack thing or something similar to that. But I heard it's kind of a mix of, you know, your standard screen ride, but then it goes into a Flight of Passage type thing, which would be amazing because Flight of Passage is one of our favorite rides.
Mm-hmm.
And being able to do something like that here at our home park would be absolutely amazing and something that Avengers Campus needs, because right now I think that people go in, try to go on Web Slingers, have a decent time on that, maybe try to see one of the shows there and then bounce out. Right now, if they're able to bring that ride to Avengers Campus, I think it's going to just bring so much more life to it. And I am ready for that. They just need to do it. So that's pretty much like all of the new things that have been announced, but like Toontown that just out of nowhere.
Yeah.
You know, announced that they're going to be revitalizing the land and, you know, bringing something new to that. Who knows?
Anything could happen. Yeah,
anything could happen. So we might see that just out of nowhere. They really don't give much of a lead time. They're just kind of like, by the way, we're going to do this. So very, very exciting. And, you know, if anything like that happens, you know that we'll be talking about it on our show. So feel free to follow us if you aren't already. And if you want us to talk about any certain topic, just feel free to DM us. We always respond. Let us know what you're curious to hear our thoughts about, and we'll discuss them. And I don't know. It's just been so fun talking all things Disney with you guys. And thank you for joining along on our journey. It's been 30 episodes so far. I still can't believe it, but we are so excited that you have been joining us. So thank you guys so much.
Thank you so much for following along and being part of our journey. It's been awesome.
So great.
Yeah. We have more coming your way.
Oh, yeah. So we will talk to you guys next week. Bye.
Bye, guys.